In today's lesson, we'll be continuing to learn how to solve similar triangles. This is a continuation of the previous lesson. In our sixth example, we've been told that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DBE. We also want to determine the length of side DE. Since these two triangles are similar, that means corresponding angles are equal and ratio of corresponding sides are equal. Let's begin by identifying the corresponding angles. It might be a little bit difficult to see, but there are two triangles located in this triangle. There's a smaller one and a bigger one. They both share the same angle of B. Now, angle D is likely equal to angle A, and angle E is likely equal to angle C. Some of you might be asking, how do I know that angle D and angle A are equal? Or how do I know that angle E and angle C are equal? Well, you can tell by the fact that these are parallel lines. And when you have parallel lines, there are patterns that you can observe. And angle D and angle A, and angle E and angle C, they match the F pattern, which you learned previously. Now, the technical term is corresponding angles. So corresponding angles are equal. So that is the F pattern. You might not be able to see it because the F is kind of upside down and facing the other way. Now that we have that out of the way, let's go ahead and redraw our two triangles. So I have a smaller triangle, which is triangle B, D, E. It has a side length of 4 over here. And the larger triangle, which I'm going to draw, this is not to scale, by the way, is B, A, C. And you know that the side length of BC is 4 plus 2, which is 6. And the base of this triangle, so side AC, is 5 centimeters. For consistency, let's color code these two triangles. So angle B and angle B are equal. Angle D and angle A are equal. And angle E and angle C are equal, which means side BD and side BA are likely corresponding sides. Side DE and side AC are corresponding sides. And side BE and side BC are also corresponding sides. Now that I've set up my smaller and larger triangle, let's write our ratio of corresponding sides. So side BD corresponds to side BA. Side DE corresponds to side AC, and side EB corresponds to side CB. So I'm just going to put an equal sign between these ratios, and I'm going to substitute in my known values. So side BD is unknown, so I'm going to leave it like it is. Side BA is unknown, I'm going to leave it as is. DE is unknown, I'm going to leave it as is. AC, we do know that, it is 5 centimeters. I know side EB is 4 centimeters, and side CB is 6 centimeters. If you recall, we want to figure out the side length of DE. So I'm going to be using this ratio for sure, and I'm also going to be using 4 over 6. Why am I not going to be using BD over BA? Well, it's completely useless. It doesn't have any numbers in it. So when I cross multiply, nothing's really going to happen. So I'm going to rewrite DE over 5 equals 4 over 6. You want to cross multiply. So I'm going to have DE multiplied by 6, which is equal to 5 multiplied by 4. So at this point, all you need to do is simplify some of these numbers. DE multiplied by 6 stays the same. 5 times 4 is 20. To get rid of the 6, you need to do the opposite operation, which is divide by 6. And I need to do that to both sides. So those 6s cancel out. DE would be equal to 20 divided by 6. You can reduce this, change it to a mixed number, or you can just throw this into your calculator and you're going to get approximately 3.33 centimeters. So therefore, the side length of DE is approximately 3.33 centimeters. In our seventh example, we've been told that the two triangles are similar. We also want to determine the length of side X and Y. Since these two triangles are similar, that means corresponding angles are equal. So right off the bat, I know that these two angles are equal because of the little symbol inside. I also know that these two angles are equal because these are opposite angles, and opposite angles are equal. And last but not least, these two angles would likely be equal due to a process of elimination. So at this point, we want to find our corresponding sides. This side is probably corresponding to this side. This side is probably corresponding to that side. And this side is corresponding to that side. How do I know? Well, that appears to be the longest side for both triangles. So since I don't have any labels for the vertices of these two triangles, I'm just going to go straight to the variables and numbers. So X corresponds to 15. 5 corresponds to Y. And 8 corresponds to 12. And I'm going to put some equal signs in between. So I want to figure out the value of x, so for sure I'm going to be using this ratio. Now I need to choose the other ratio which I'm going to use. I'm going to be using 8 over 12. Why 8 over 12? Well, the numerator and denominator both have numbers. Okay, so let's go ahead and rewrite that. So I have x over 15, which is equal to 8 over 12. At this point, I want to cross multiply. So I have x multiplied by 12, which is equal to 15 multiplied by 8. So x multiplied by 12 stays the same. I want to simplify 15 multiplied by 8, which is 120. So I want to isolate x. I want to figure out what it's equal to, but it's stuck with this 12. So I'm going to have to do the opposite operation, which is divide by 12. And I'm going to have to do that to both sides. So those 12s cancel out. X is now equal to 120 divided by 12, which is just 10 units. Now that I've figured out what X is equal to, let's try and solve for Y, which means I'm going to be using this ratio as well as 8 over 12. So let's go ahead and write it down below over here. So I'm going to rewrite 5 over y equals 8 over 12. Let's cross multiply. So you're left with 5 multiplied by 12 equals y multiplied by 8. Let's simplify 5 times 12. So 5 times 12 is 60. And the y multiplied by 8 stays the same. Now, if you want to isolate y, you need to get rid of the 8. So you do the opposite operation. You divide both sides by 8. Those 8s cancel out. And you can just put 60 divided by 8 into your calculator. And you are going to get 7.5 is equal to y. So therefore, I just figured out that the side length of x is 10 units. And the side length of y is 7.5 units.